Oh, God, it's you. You scared the crap out of me creeping up like that. What do you want? Look, if you want a freebie, that's okay with me. Keep away from me. I'm warning you.
I'll come straight to the point, Mrs. Powell. I'd like to talk to any of the prisoners who knew Tina Gibson.
Oh, that covers a fair range. She was released only yesterday.
She's dead. Murdered last night. Oh. We think it's the same killer who got Penny Seymour, which makes two girls killed soon after release from this prison.
I see.
We're hoping one of the prisoners can give us a clue to the killer's identity.
Oh, no. I doubt whether they could tell you anything, even if they were willing to speak to the police.
I understand that. But this is someone knocking off working girls, which might encourage them to talk. We're hoping one of them might recognize him if he was a regular client.
So you've got a description?
Unfortunately, no, but we're hoping somebody might recognize that.
The initials JF. Oh, my God. It's, Joan Ferguson. Well, this is the staff room where the officers keep their personal belongings.
I see. And which is Officer Ferguson's locker?
Fourth one down. I think we should wait until Miss Ferguson is here before you go through her belongings, if you don't mind. She won't be long.
Fair enough. What's this Ferguson like, Mrs. Powell? Anything I should know about her?
She's a good officer.
Now, I meant as a person.
I don't think it's my
place. Is that for me, Mrs. Powell?
Yes, Miss Ferguson. This is Detective Inspector Thorne, Detective Wells.
Gentlemen.
I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Thank you, Mrs. Powell. Miss Ferguson, would you mind closing the door? Believe you own a pair of black leather gloves?
Yes, I do. Oh, that is, I did until this morning.
What does that mean?
Well, yesterday, when I finished my shift, I put them in my locker, and this morning they were gone.
Did you report that?
No, of course not. Well, why all this interest in a pair of gloves?
Were they locked away?
No, there's nothing of any value in my locker.
Can we take a look?
Not until you give me an explanation for all these questions.
Is this your glove?
Yes, it is. Where'd you find it?
It was found next to the body of a known prostitute last night. She'd been murdered. Now, can we take a look inside your locker?
That's impossible. I mean, how would it get there?
Well, that's what we're trying to find out. What were your whereabouts last night, Miss Ferguson?
I went straight home after I finished work and I stayed there all night. You don't surely think
that I... We're not making any accusations at this stage, but we would appreciate it if you'd come down to the station and answer a few questions.
Now?
If it's convenient.
Well, I'm afraid it's not at the moment. I have a shift to finish.
We are rather short-staffed today.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize there's anyone in here.
Anything?
No, sir.
All right, we'll discuss it further when you finish work. At what time can we expect you?
Oh, about 6:30.
6:30 would be fine. Just ask for me at the charge counter. They'll send you up to my office.
Very well. I'll be leaving here about 6 o'clock.
I'll be waiting for you. See you then.
Anything wrong?
Hmm? Oh, no. No, of course not. I'll be on my rounds if you want me.
I wonder what the police want with her.
Maybe they've found out she's only masquerading as a woman. Anyway, I've seen the girls. I'm off.
Look, I might call into the halfway house later on and meet the new tenants. That is, if you don't mind.
No, we'd love to see you. Only don't make it too late. I'm going out again tonight to see if I can pick up a few more homeless waifs.
Right.
See you later.
Bye-bye.
It's bloody rotten. It's always the poor pros who get it in the neck.
I mean, it's a bad enough job as it is without having to worry about some weirdo out there who's going to bump you off.
Occupational hazard.
Here, B. I wonder if she was a friend of Penny's. Maybe there's some kind of tie-up. I bet you there was. Hey, Mr. Faulkner, have they released the name of the girl that was murdered last night?
Well, if they have, I haven't heard. I thought you might be able to tell me. You women always seem to find out the news before I do. Everything under control, B?
Just hunky-dory, Mr. Faulkner.
Good. Well, keep up the good work, ladies.
Bloody hell, I'm getting low on fags. I'm not going to be able to last till the next buyer.
I'll get you some.
Oh, yeah? And how much will that cost?
Normal price.
What? B, I know you've got an art of gold, but what's the catch?
No catch. Anyone else run short of supplies, just let me know.
Oh, yeah? And how are you going to do that?
Ah, now, that is my business. You come up with the dough, I'll come up with the goodies.
All right, then. I'll have a carton of fags. Well, when will I get them?
Sometime today, we will.
Sit down. You didn't bring any bags?
No, I didn't know you wanted any. I'm here to see Judy Bryant.
Yes, I know. She isn't here at the moment. You can talk to me if you like.
Well, that'll be nice.
I'm her partner, Tony Berman.
I'm her friend, Helen Smart.
I see. And you're thinking of moving in with us, are you?
What a nice thought. But I do have a very nice place of my own, and this is not quite what my customers have come to expect.
I thought...
You don't understand, love. I've known Judy for years. I'm simply here for a visit.
Oh, sorry. I guess I got a bit carried away. Well, look, Jude's still in Sydney.
Right, and you're the bloke who's going around trying to get the kids on the street to move in here, yes?
Yeah, that's right. You've heard about me.
I've heard. Lots of luck. Look, Judy has my number. Why don't you get her to give me a call when she comes back?
Yeah, sure.
Like, how long do you think that might be?
Well, I think...
Good morning.
Beryl, surely you don't have to carry the birds around with you all the time. They'd be perfectly safe here.
Well, you see, those other two girls don't like them. And they've even threatened to get rid of them.
I'm sure Trixie and Francine wouldn't harm them. I'll have a word with them if you like.
Thank you, Tony. Come on, my babies.
I would have sworn those birds were a different colour last night.
Well, they all look the same to me, but I'll tell you one thing. You got that one off the streets just in time.
What little secrets are we hiding away? Give.
These are private papers and have nothing to do with anyone else. Take your hands off me. They're personal papers and have nothing to do with you or the prison.
Shut up. Well, well, well. A business partnership between you and your former employer. Stinks of collusion, doesn't it?
Oh, don't be ridiculous. It's all perfectly legal.
Oh, I'm sure it is. Your ex-boss, a likely suspect for arson and murder, paying off his former employee who was originally charged with the crimes. I'm sure the police would be inclined to agree with me.
Look, I'll give you anything you want. Do whatever you want if you'll just give me those papers back.
Oh, you'll cooperate, all right. And just to make sure, I'll keep these in a safe place. Oh, don't be an idiot, Fields. I've got you right where I want you, and you know it. Now, here's the first little job I want you to do. I want to know what B. Smith is up to with Faulkner. You'll find that out for me, won't you?
You're lucky you caught me. I was just about to leave.
Oh, the conscientious social worker takes to the streets, eh?
Doesn't sound too good, does it?
No, it does not. Neither does that. What is it?
Good question. You in there, Beryl? My God. Looks like a bloody aviary.
Oh. You've met my little friends.
Oh, Beryl.
Why would somebody try to set you up for these murders, Miss Ferguson?
I've been a prison officer for a long time, Inspector. One makes a lot of enemies.
Yes, we've got a report on you here. Prisoner bashing?
Well, you'll get accused of that at some stage.
Suspected lesbianism?
Where did you get that from?
We have our contact.
Yes. Ex-prisoners, no doubt. One doesn't have to be a popular officer to be a good one. You should know that.
Nevertheless, you did know both victims, and they were both through Wentworth recently.
Oh, for God's sake, it's a setup. The clue they left couldn't have been more obvious.
Perhaps, but you have no alibi for your movements last night, and you have no alibi for your movements on the night of the previous murder.
I've told you. I was at home all night on both occasions.
But no proof.
Inspector, I'm tired and I would like to leave. Now, you either arrest me if you have enough evidence and let me call my lawyer, or just let me go.
If your gloves were stolen, as you claim, they would have had to have been taken either late yesterday afternoon or early last night. Now, that doesn't leave much time for somebody to smuggle them out.
You don't know those women. They spend their lives trying to set us up. They've tried to set me up before and it didn't work. And it won't work now. May I go?
All right. No further questions at this time. We'll be in touch.
No doubt.
Hello, B.
A bit jumpy, aren't you?
Every time somebody sneaks up on me, I think it's Joan Ferguson.
Oh, well, you can relax. She has finished for the day.
Yes, I know. She was due at the police station after work.
Where did you hear that?
When I was working down in reception this morning.
Why do they want her down there?
No idea, but I heard her tell the detectives that she'd call in after work.
Detectives? I wonder what the freak's been up to.
No idea, but she was certainly looking worried.
Oh, good. Anything that worries her has got to be good for us. Well done, Babs. It's a nice little position you got for yourself down there. You could be quite a lot of help to us from time to time, if you're smart.
Yes, well, of course I'll do whatever's possible.
Great. And in exchange, if you find yourself short of supplies, just let me know. I'm arranging a special delivery.
Oh, how do you manage that?
Ah, that's my business. And keep an eye on the freak. Pays to keep one step ahead of her.
Yes, if you can. The trick's going to be keeping one step ahead of both of you.
You missed it. Now you let me see that face. Just once, let me look at that face before I smash it in. Come on!
You know a prostitute named Helen Smart?
Yes. She was in here recently.
So I believe.
Not her, too.
Not quite. An attempt was made on her life last night at 9 p.m, but she managed to fight her attacker off.
And you suspect me. Did the killer leave another glove?
No, he didn't.
He?
So Smart assures us. It was dark at the time, but she's quite certain it was a man.
So I'm in the clear?
Not quite. Oh, we know it wasn't you last night. We know exactly where you were at 9 p.m.
You had me followed. Well, then why am I still a suspect?
It's possible this latest attack is not connected with the previous two.
It's ridiculous. They must be connected.
Not necessarily. There are certain discrepancies.
Such as?
Well, for a start, whoever attacked Smart obviously knew her address. She was attacked inside, not in the street. He'd broken in, removed the fuse from the fuse box, and was waiting for her when she got home.
So?
The first two were successful. They were quick and remarkably efficient. No sign of a prolonged struggle. His last one was clumsy and had failed. Different pattern altogether.
So he changed his pattern and botched it up.
And then it's possible it's some nutcase cashing in on the apparent success of the first two murders. And there's still the glove.
So I'm no better off.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. Well, you've got a new avenue to explore. I thought you'd like to know.
Oh, yeah. You've brightened my day. Can I go now? I have work to do.
Yeah. We'll be in touch.
Now, surely you don't still suspect her.
Her glove was found beside one of the victims. It's too important to ignore.
Yes, but she claims it was stolen.
She also claims the inmates are setting her up. Now, let's approach this from a different angle altogether. How many men have access to the staff room?
Well, there's Steve Faulkner.
How does Ferguson get on with him?
They used to get on very well. I think it has changed lately, but come
on. Was he
on,
working you... last night?
Yes, he was.
Well, that rules him out. Who else?
There's the new male nurse, Neil Murray.
Was he on duty last night?
No. He would have left about the same time as Joan.
All right. We'll start with him.
You know, if you keep putting yourself on sick call, someone will take you off to hospital and you'll have to have some tests.
No, not a chance. I'd have to be dead on my feet before they send me.
What are you doing here?
I'm on sick call, Mrs. Powell.
Again? Who authorised it?
Officer Barry.
Did she? All right, I'll have a word with her. Wait outside. I'll get an officer to take you back.
Mr. Murray, this is Detective Inspector Thorne. He'd like to have a few words with you. I'll leave you to it. I've got a lot of work to do.
Thanks, Mrs. Powell.
Right. You will wait here until an officer comes and gets you.
Just a routine inquiry, Mr. Murray, concerning the recent murders of Tina Gibson and Penny Seymour and the attempted murder last night of Helen Smart.
Another one?
Yes, we're working on the assumption that all three incidents are connected with Wentworth. As you know, all three spent some time in here recently.
I see.
Now, it's just an angle, but we've got to check it out. Do you have anything to do with these women?
No, not much. I'm only the nurse. I only see them when they're sick. And those three seemed healthy enough.
Yes, well, two of them aren't any more. And where were you last night at around 9 p.m, Mr. Murray?
I mean, I'm under suspicion.
As I said, these are just routine questions.
Well, Well, as a matter of fact, I was at the movies.
I see. By yourself?
Yeah.
Pity. Then I suppose you can prove it.
Well, not really, but... Wait a minute, though. I should still have the ticket stub somewhere. Ah, here we are.
Complete with date and session time. Oh, that's fine, Mr. Murray. Should any other questions crop up, I take it you'll be available?
Oh, yes, of course.
Good. Thanks for your help.
Hi.
Been a bit extra careful, aren't you?
How do you mean?
Well, you don't usually lock your things up when you're on duty.
I'm going to in future. It's too easy for things to go missing in this place.
You can say that again.
Yeah, well, I better get to it.
And this copper, he was making inquiries about the murders of Penny and Tina Gibson.
Tina, sure, she was the second one. Poor kid didn't last long after she got out of here, did she?
And that's not all. Helen Smart's been attacked.
What? Not Helen? She's not dead, is she?
No, apparently not. She fought him off, but he still got away.
Oh, thank God for that. Well, did she see who it was?
Well, couldn't have done. That's why they were questioning Neil.
Well, I haven't arrested him then.
No, it didn't sound like they was going to, but I had to leave before they'd finished. But I hope he's going to be all right.
I wouldn't worry. They're probably questioning everyone.
Yeah, I suppose so. God, I could have to do with a smoke.
Oh, that reminds me. Your order.
Oh, Bea, you're a marvel. Here, where'd you get them?
Now, you know better than to ask that. Here, you better hide them before a screw cops you.
Here, girls, anyone like a fag?
Yeah. You're being extremely generous, aren't you, Latham?
It's just a pack somebody owed me, Miss Ferguson.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Well, I must say I'm relieved you're not dragging any of my staff away.
Well, Murray's is not exactly watertight.
The theatre ticket?
Inconclusive, I'm afraid. He would have had time to buy the ticket before Smart was attacked.
So he's still a suspect?
In my book, everyone in this prison is suspect, apart from the women behind bars, and I'm not too sure about them.
Does that include me?
Oh, we're pretty safe with you. Besides, I've checked. You're either home with your family or working here on the nights of the murders. Good morning, Mrs. Powell.
Oh, excuse me, Mrs. Powell.
What?
I've just got a bit of a problem. I wonder if you could give me a hand.
Yeah, right.
Smith, I want to see you outside.
Oh, right, Mr. Faulkner. Hey, Chrissie, take over the press for me, will you?
Yes, sir.
How's it going?
Like clockwork. She'll take the bait any minute now. But she's being very cautious.
Well, she's been around a long time. She's not going to rush into it until she's sure. She's onto us.
Okay, make it look good.
Come on, Smith. Don't give me that crap about not knowing anything. Now spit it out.
It's the truth, Mr. Faulkner. Honest, I would tell you if I knew, wouldn't I?
Like hell. Go on, get back into work. My claims when they want to be, aren't they?
Trouble?
No, nothing I can't handle. I've got an afternoon tea break on. I'll see you later. Well, that's the latest contribution.
Well, I'm not at all happy about this. It's totally unethical.
I know how you feel, but I can't think of any alternative. Either way, the end must justify the means.
Well, there must be another way. It's acting in collusion with the prisoners against a fellow officer, and I don't like it.
I don't think anyone likes it, Mrs. Davidson. I get the feeling it won't be too much longer before we know for sure.
Well, I only hope so.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's all right. I was on the way. Thanks, Mrs. Davidson.
I thought I'd better bring you up to date on the murder inquiries.
Oh, yes, I believe the police have been here.
Detective Inspector Thorne's handling the case. Now, he'll be calling in to see you this afternoon.
Well, you'd better give me the details.
I tell you what, I'd rather be working in here in that bloody kitchen. Paddy and me, we worked our fingers to the bone this morning.
Oh, yeah, I can imagine.
Well, what about me? You weren't on your own, you know.
You did nothing but bludge as usual.
Well, get stuffed.
Don't be so common. Hey, what is it with Chrissie? She came flouncing in the kitchen, handing out fags to everyone.
Yeah, I thought she'd lost her buy-up privileges for this week.
Well, that doesn't mean she has to miss out altogether, does it?
I thought there was something fishy going on.
Oh, come on, Bea, let us in on it. How are you getting the stuff in?
All you have to worry about is the fact that it's coming in.
Hey, you're not dealing with a freak, are you?
You gotta be kidding. If she catches me, I can kiss any chance of my parole. Goodbye.
Well, listen, if there's anything I can do to help, you know, being a front runner or something, give us a yell, eh?
Thanks, Patty. I might keep you up to that. Hey, look, everybody. I want a disturbance in the dining room at lunchtime, but it has to be when Steve Faulkner is the only screw on duty.
But there's always more than one screw on duty in the dining room.
Not today. Trust me.
Well, what's it for? If I'm going to get into trouble, I want to know that it's going to be worthwhile.
Oh, don't worry. It's for a good cause. But I want everyone involved, and I don't want the screw singling anyone out, OK?
Yeah.
Right, well, here we go. Now, remember, all watch me from a queue.
All right, ladies, the dining room's now open for business.
Oh, these bikers are a menace. Yeah, it's weird sometimes they're going to drive right in here. Look at that one. He looks as if he's straight out of the movies.
Maxine!
Better shut your mouth, Mum. You might catch a fly.
Oh, well, I wasn't expecting you. Well, I was, but oh, not like this.
Yeah, well, thought I'd pay a surprise visit.
Yeah, well, you did, didn't you? Leave your bike here and we'll go outside and have some coffee in the garden.
Ah, terrific.
George, look after things for a while, will you?
No worries, Miss Daniels.
Don't forget you've got a session with Dr. Weissman after lunch, Lawson.
How could I forget? It's all I've been thinking about since I saw him last time.
You're not worried about it, are you? He's pretty sure he can help you.
Hypnotise me.
No, it doesn't hurt. It's very relaxing.
Yeah, I'll bet.
After lunch, all right?
All right, Dawn, break it up! I said break it up!
What the hell started this?
I don't know. It happened too quickly.
Okay, Smith. All right. Then perhaps you want to speak to Mrs. Davidson. Stay here, keep an eye on them, and get this mess cleaned up.
All right, you heard. Let's get on with it.
What on earth are you doing still riding that awful motorbike?
Oh, Mum, it's not awful. And anyway, stacks of chicks ride them nowadays.
Oh, not nice girls. Oh, that leather jacket makes you look so tough. So nice when I visited you in that terrible place.
Well, I can hardly wear a dress when I'm riding the bike now, can I? The skirt'd be halfway around me neck, and that wouldn't look so nice either, would it?
Well, all the same,
Mum, look, apart from that day in Wentworth, we haven't seen each other for a couple of years. Let's not pick up from where we left off, eh?
All right. I suppose you're too big to be told now.
Yeah, I am. So, what's the news with the family? How's Pauline?
Oh, she's very excited about the wedding. We all are. She did want you to be one of the bridesmaids, but we didn't know where you were.
Yeah, well, somehow I don't think I'm the bridesmaid type. Still, I suppose I could get some of the bikies to give her an escort to the church.
Oh, I don't think that'd fit in very well.
No. Suppose you're right. Still, I'd love to see her. Where's she staying?
Oh, she's sharing a flat with a couple of girlfriends in town. I was too far travelling from here every day.
Where's Dad?
Oh, he's gone to town on business. He'll be back later on this afternoon. Where have you been since you paid the fine?
Oh, hanging around. I thought he might have come to see me.
Oh, well, it hasn't been easy for him, Maxine. Not knowing where you were or what you were doing. And then finding out you're in that horrible place.
Yeah. Well, might hang around for a bit then, eh? Say good day to him.
What was the cause of this, Mr. Corkman?
I really don't know, Mrs. Davidson. It happened too quickly.
Who were the ringleaders?
I'm sorry, I couldn't see.
Surely there must have been some indication.
Mrs. Powell, call them to attention. I shall try to get to the bottom of it. All right, everyone, stop what you're doing and listen to Mrs. Davidson.
I do not have time to waste on these petty squabbles. So if the perpetrators will step forward now, the rest of you need not be punished. Smith? Gaffney? Very well, then. As the guilty ones refuse to step forward, you will all be punished. Aww. You have been warned before. I will not tolerate mass insubordination. All buyer privileges tomorrow are cancelled. You only have yourselves to blame. Mrs. Powell, see that this mess is cleaned up and the prisoners return to work, whether they have eaten or not. Miss Ferguson, have Birdsworth cleaned up and then bring her to my office. Okay, you heard. Get on with it.
Go on, move it.
Satisfied now, Smith?
Perfectly.
G'day, Dad.
When you eventually decided to turn up.
Yeah. How'd you be? Listen, thanks for coughing up with the fine.
Don't thank me, thank your mother. I did it for her. And also for your sister, too. Didn't want her getting a telegram from prison at a wedding reception.
I thought you might have done it for me.
What for? You seem to be pretty happy with your kind. Couldn't care less about the way we worry about what's happened to you. Just take a look at yourself. A real little roughie. A bikie's mole. Do me a favor. Tell me, is this what you walked out on us for?
No. I got out because you were bugging me. I had to be free.
Free? I noticed how free you were when I paid your bail. Now look, come back here. Don't start racing off again like that. I paid good money so you could be at your sister's wedding.
Stuff the wedding. Stuff the family and stuff you too. I should never have come back in the first place. And don't worry about your precious money. You'll get it back. Every bloody cent of it.
Come in.
Sorry, we're a bit late, Doctor. Some trouble in the dining room that had to be sorted out.
That's right, Mrs. Powell. I was beginning to wonder if Paddy was going to change her mind.
Oh, no. Nothing like that. Okay, I'll leave you to it. Give me a ring when you've finished.
Thank you, Mrs. Powell. Well, Paddy, how are you feeling? Come sit down. Please.
What are you going to do?
Nothing, we're just going to talk.
Thought you were going to hypnotise me.
That's what hypnosis is. Relaxing, talking.
Yeah, and run around the room barking like a dog.
The last time I tried that, I got bitten on the ankle. But don't worry about that. Now, I can't make you do anything you don't want to do. Just trust me, all right?
It was a mistake trying for parole so soon after messing up your last chance.
Well, I wasn't going to let them stick me in an old people's home, was I? Anyway, it's going to be different now because when I get out, I'm going to stay in the halfway house with Judy. Oh, hello, Mr. B. What are you doing here?
It's worth mind your own business.
As a matter of fact, I have an appointment to see Mrs. Davidson.
Well, I hope you have better luck than I did. Hey. How's Maxie? Have you heard from her?
Well, I haven't seen her lately, of course, but I think she's all right.
Oh, she'll be all right. Especially when she comes back in here. And she'll be back. Idiots like her can't stay away from the place.
Don't talk about her like that.
Shut your mouth, Birdsworth, or you'll be on a charge.
Don't worry, Lizzie. I'll find Maxine and keep an eye on her.
Oh, good on you, Mr. B. She's a dear little
kid,
isn't she?
Come on, Birdsworth, move it.
All right, Miss Ferguson.
Oh, that was a great idea, Smith. Now, because of you, we've lost our buy-up privileges for tomorrow. Now, what did you hope to gain?
Oh, shut up, Margo. You'll get your goodies.
Oh, yeah? How are you going to manage that, mastermind?
Don't worry, I'll do it. All you have to do is get your orders in by tonight, and I'll handle the rest. And that goes for the rest of you as well.
Come off it. Okay, so you've got some deal going for the odd carton of fags. Mate, you're going to need a tip truck to get in enough stuff for all of us.
I said I'd bring the stuff in, and I will. This is going to be a lot better than the usual arrangement. It'll make our shopping time much more flexible. So get your orders in, girls. Oh, how'd you go, love?
No good.
Oh, never mind. You get another chance.
Oh, I should have taken that other offer while it lasted. It's not bloody fair. I thought I was going to have to stay in that old person's home for good.
Well, it'll teach you to investigate all the possibilities in future. But sometimes things aren't really as bad as they seem. Isn't that right, girls?
Less talk and more work.
I mean, personally, I quite like birds, but I have to draw the line somewhere, don't I?
And very soon, I'd say. Well, I might have a simple solution. I've been thinking about it since Mrs. Morris told me.
Anything, please.
I have some friends who live in the country and run kennels. Now, there's a possibility that Beryl could go there.
The country?
Yes. They're looking for someone to live in and help with light duties around the place, and the best thing about that is that Beryl could take her birds with her.
That'd be terrific. Well, how soon could you get in touch with them?
Well, I'll try to ring this afternoon or tomorrow.
Detective Inspector Thorne.
Oh, yes. You'll have to excuse me now, Mr. Berman, but I'll be in touch with you as soon as I hear.
Yes, of course. Thanks for your help. There's nothing I can do to help Lizzie's cause.
No, I'm afraid not. Oh, not yet, anyway. Hello, Inspector.
Sorry I interrupted you.
Oh, not at all. This is Tony Berman, who works at the halfway house. He's just leaving.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Well, thanks again, Mrs. Davidson.
Now, I want you to think back to that office party. But you won't only be just remembering. You'll actually be there again. You'll be reliving it all again. And you'll see everything in detail, everything you felt, everything you thought. Now, you back at the party?
Yeah.
Good. Now, what's happening?
Oh, it's a good party. Mr. Crosby is leaving. Bull had a few drinks. I think Mr. Crosby's had a few too many. Looks like he's getting lecherous with Elaine. She doesn't seem to mind. Josie's doing all right. She's got two of them. Not that Brian's going to be much use to her. I think he'd rather be getting off with Will. Oh, I cut it out, Trev. I know what you're up to. What? Oh, don't be silly. Oh, God, of course I'm on the pill. What's it to you, anyway? Where are we gonna go? Oh, no. Oh, no, Trev, not in there. What do you think you're doing? Oh, no, not in here. Come on, let's go back out. No, Trev, don't. Let me go, you hear me? Let me go.
It's all right, Paddy, it's all right, you're quite safe.
Let me go, let me out. Oh, I'm sorry, Mum, I won't do it again, I promise. Oh, let me out, Mummy, please.
It's all right.
Oh, Mummy.
Paddy, it's all right, Paddy.
Mummy.
Relax.
Oh, I won't do it again, I promise.
Just relax,
let
Paddy.
Me out.
Relax.
Let me out.
Relax. Just relax.
Oh, good day. How'd it go? Well, come on. Was it as bad as you thought it was going to be?
In some ways.
Yeah, what ways?
Oh, it didn't hurt. In fact, I don't actually remember feeling anything while I was under. I can remember him talking to me as I was coming out of it. He was saying I'd feel relaxed and peaceful. It was funny, I did. It was a good feeling.
Oh, it sounds terrific. So how come you're so down?
Well, afterwards, played me back this tape he'd made of the session. Well, it was pretty terrible. I screamed and ranted and raved like a maniac.
What about?
Being in the storeroom with Trevor.
Must have been pretty rough.
But B, in the end, I was screaming at my mother. It was as if I blamed her for locking me in there.
Why?
Well, I don't know. I love my mother. She was a bit strict, but she was fair. Wasn't easy for her, but she always did what she thought was best.
Well, there must be some tie-up somewhere. Maybe that's what Weissman's trying to bring out.
I'm scared, B. I don't think I want to know. I don't want to go on with it.
Now, listen to me. Weissman knows his job. He helped me once, so I know what I'm talking about.
What happened?
It's a long story. It happened a long time ago. Water under the bridge. Anyway, that's enough soul-searching for one day. Let's go into the rec room and join the others.
Oh, I want to work on this. Relaxes me.
You can bring it with you. Hey, this is great. Who taught you how to sew, your mother?
No, she never had time for that sort of thing. My grandmother showed me.
Well, that's terrific.
I thought Judy might be able to sell it at the halfway house.
I'd say it'd be a dead cert.
G'day, social worker. Here you're looking for loose women.
Come on in. I wondered where you were. Thought you might have been in trouble again. Hey, you're not, are you?
Nah, I came back because I couldn't stay away from you any longer.
Hey, I saw Lizzie this afternoon at Wentworth. She was asking about you.
Ah, she's a good old stick. You know, when she gets out of prison, I'm going to make her honorary member of the bikey club.
I can just imagine Lizzie in leather gear.
Yeah, it'd be a sight all right, wouldn't it?
Well, where have you been since I last saw you?
Hanging around.
I thought you might have been staying with your parents.
Yeah, well, I called in to see them.
And?
Nothing's changed.
Sorry, Max.
Oh, what the hell? Who cares?
How'd you get up there?
Well, how do you reckon? On me bike.
But, Maxie, your license has been suspended.
Yeah, well, they gotta catch me first. So, I thought I might shack up here for a while, okay?
Yeah, of course. Look, you know what'll happen when they do catch you.
If they catch me. So, where can I crash for the night?
Well, I don't know whether that will be of any use to you. The visitors usually aren't allowed to wander around unescorted.
Berman?
Yes, that's the young man who was in the office when you arrived. He works at the halfway house.
Oh, yes, I remember. He seems to call in a fair bit.
Yes, he's become quite a regular. He likes the prisoners to feel there's somewhere they can go when they leave here.
What's he like?
He seems a very nice person, very enthusiastic about his work.
Does he have access to the staff room?
Yes, he usually pops in there when he visits to have a cup of coffee and a chat.
Well, I think I might go along and have a talk with him.
Oh, surely you don't think he has anything to do with the murders?
Mrs. Davidson, at the moment I'm looking for a man who has access to the staff room, knows when the prisoners are released and on what charges, and either works here or is a regular visitor. Now, under the circumstances, I think young Berman is worth a visit, don't you?
Well, well, if it isn't King Kong turned little old sewing lady.
Lay off, Margo.
What's the matter? I make you drop a stitch or something? You know, I reckon you shouldn't be doing needlework. I reckon you should be doing basket weaving.
Shut your mouth, Margo, or I'll shut it for you.
Oh, yeah? Mother hen looking after a tough egg, eh? Well, I'd watch out for this one because I think it's a bit cracked.
You know, Margo, I think it's about time you helped with the craft work.
I can't sew.
Well, it's about time you learned. It's very relaxing. It'll give your mouth a rest.
Look, I was just having a bit of a joke.
Well, I'm not laughing. Get off your butt and give Paddy a hand with that quilt.
Look, I told you, I can't sew.
And Paddy will show you how, won't you, Paddy?
Yeah. Sure, here.
Make sure you get it right. Because if you don't, Margo, I will use this needle and thread to sew up your mouth.
And then this chick with the blonde hair with the purple streak through it suddenly threw her arms around me like this. Yes. And she says, sure, I'll come and live in your house, but it'll cost you. Well, I said, look, no, you don't understand. It's a halfway house. And she says, well, halfway to where? I don't want to move too far out of town.
Come on. I won't bite. Not unless you want me to.
Hi.
Mr. Berman. Detective Inspector Thorne. This is Detective Wells. I met you in Mrs. Davidson's office at Wentworth today.
Oh, yeah, of course. Come on in.
Thank you.
Sorry about the locked door. We haven't got our permit yet. Come through. Inspector, I'd like you to... sit down.
Thank you, Mr. Berman. We'll stand.
Well, how can I help you, gentlemen?
Just a few questions, Mr. Berman. We're investigating the murders of two women who were recently inmates of Wentworth and the attempted murder last night of one Helen Smart.
Helen Smart? Oh, that's awful. She was...
Yeah?
Oh, nothing. Do you have any leads?
Yeah. I understand you frequent Wentworth quite regularly.
Well, not exactly regularly. Occasionally, yes.
You have access to the staff room?
I sometimes have a cup of coffee there. Why?
We've reason to believe that Officer Ferguson's gloves were stolen from her locker. You know Officer Ferguson, of course.
Yeah. But I have no
idea... How do you get on with her?
Well, I don't have much to do with her.
One of her gloves was discovered near the body.
Oh, then you think it's her.
Last night's attempted murder was done by a man. Where were you last night about 9 p.m, Mr. Berman?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. but that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing.